Good morning. It is so wonderful to be gathered here this morning. I want to welcome all of you to this service of worship. My name is Pam White. I'm the senior pastor here, and it is good to have this opportunity to be together this morning, whether you're gathered here in the worship space or whether you're joining us online. If you were a guest, I want to extend a special welcome. If we can do anything to let you know more about our church, to help you feel more welcome here, please, please let one of us know. During this time of worship, it is important for us to know that you are individually here as well. We'll be talking about the ways that each of us individually is a part of the body of Christ. And so this morning, if you would take a minute to text your attendance to us, if you haven't already done that, 469-314-9951 is that number. Hopefully you've got that saved in your phone and you can just pull it up, put your name and the number of people that are worshiping. If you're online, you can add the word online after it, and that lets us know who all is with us in this time. Scripture tells us that when trees are planted by streams, they receive the nourishment, the refreshment that they need, and we are called to do the same as Christians. And so I hope that this morning's worship is a stream that nourishes your dry, parched soul. And I hope that in this time of prelude, you will take a minute to just ready your hearts to worship together. As the in our time of prelude, the acolytes will be coming forward to bring the light of Christ in. And if you are worshiping online, I hope that you will also use this time to do something to ready your space so that we can receive what God has for us this morning. Let us worship.
Will you please stand with me as you were able and join me in our call to worship? In one spirit, we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, indigenous people, and later comers to this land. The body does not consist of one member, but of many. If one member suffers, we all suffer together with it. If one member is honored, all rejoice together with it. We are the body of Christ and individually members of it. Baptized by the Spirit, we claim our membership of the body of Christ. Let us worship as one together. And now as one body, let us affirm our faith together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated.
Where there is love, no I'm Teresa Smith. Currently, I serve as the Church Council Chair for First Rowlett, and it is such an honor. The Church Council Chair is responsible for all of the different committees in helping to bring the work that all the different committees are doing together and use that to create vision and create mission for our church going forward. And some of the ways that that is so fulfilling and so enriching for me is the community of First Rowlett. And the thing I think that sets our church apart is how multi-generational our community is. How, you know, there's generations and generations of people. My parents were members here, so that whole group of people, some of those people I've known, gosh, over 45 years. And being able to be part of that group and being outside the walls of this church with different groups. Some of mine and Scott's best friends are people that we've met in this church, that we travel with, that we socialize with, that we support each other. There's good times, but knowing that our family is here to support each other during the difficult times as well, that's what it's about. That's what our church family's about, and that's what us building this family together, it's why it's so important. You will never be alone. You will always have someone here who is part of your church family and part of your church community to support you.
So I think community is a very important aspect of the church. I think it's equally as important as worship, but it's very different than worship. It's where we come together, we support each other, we have a chance to share with each other in a smaller setting maybe than we would in worship. Some of my closest friendships, our closest friendships as a couple, have come from the community that this church has provided. We've raised our kids here. We've built our marriage here, basically. And the closest friendships that we have and the most important relationships in our life are due to the community here at First Rowlett.
Hi, I'm Scott Weiss, my wife Kay, and we want to say something about the importance of having God and a church family in our life. It has been wonderful for us. I was diagnosed first part of last year with cancer, and going through that journey, it would have been extremely difficult without having a community to fall back on and to give us support, along with knowing ourselves that God was behind us and with us. It was an amazing journey and still is, but it's been a lifesaver. I've got a stack of cards about a half a foot deep from a lot of people that I know, a lot of people that I don't know, and it's been wonderful.
I am so thankful for God, our church family, who has helped us with every minute detail of Scott's recovery. We have not wanted or needed for anything because our friends, our family, our church has taken care of us beyond measures. I can't tell you what a great support it is to know that I can pick up the phone, I could hit anybody in the directory and know that there's somebody there for me to talk to. Being a caregiver at times is challenging, and you know there's a lot of people that are professionals at it. So I'm thankful for this church and everything that God has provided for us during this time. Because of these challenges, we know that if anyone has similar problems or needed direction in any way or just a shoulder to cry on, we would be gladly available to help out in any way that we could. I think that we've got pretty good experience at it right now. So.
I am grateful this morning for such a testimony from Scott and Kay and the power of the community of prayer. And I'm grateful for a church community that joins together in prayer and shares in the faith that as we gather together to pray, that we are joining into a church that is universal, a church that is joined together with the churches that are across this world and sharing a common faith. faith and in reaching to God, who is our rock. So I invite you to join us today as we gather together for prayer. Let us go to the Lord. Good and loving Father, we come together this morning with praise and wonderment. By the power of the Spirit living within us and around us, we are united with a world, a unity that does not just hold us to this church, but outward, to the church found all over our state, our country, our continent, our world. So as we pray, we ask, Lord, to hear the prayers of your church body as we lift up to you the joys and concerns that are on our hearts and the events that we have experienced. In moments like that which we have shared this week, moments that we've watched the earth shake the communities of Haiti, in civil turmoil uproot the systems of Afghanistan, and a virus that we continue to pray for its eradication make waves in our communities. While some who seek help and ask where help will come from, we seek you in your presence. For it is in your word that we are reminded that it is not in our power, but through your power that our help comes from. You are our help, and you are our strength. We seek that strength. We seek your presence today. God, we pray this day that we may be found as faithful people, that our faith allows for you to be our strength. Help us, Lord, to overcome our pride and selfish desires, so to seek the ways that we can be an example of your strength in this time of need. Help us to live into the example of Jesus Christ, our Savior, who taught us to pray the prayer we pray now, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Working on the
We are working on a building, working and building. That's what we are called to do as a church. Together in this season, we are looking at what it means to build it up, to be a part of building God's kingdom, to be a part of building back up our community here, our congregation, our engagement with one another, and then especially to be building up our own faith practices in our own lives, to look at what it means to get back into a rhythm and a routine. In order to do this, we're talking about different elements of actual construction of building on the different weeks. Last week, we talked about the foundation. What does it mean for worship to be the foundation of all that we do? Everything that we do as a community of faith comes from this place. It is important that we are here in a space where we can encounter God and where we are renewed in God's call in our lives, so that we can then leave this space and continue the work of Christ. And so this week we look at another aspect. We're looking at community and fellowship. And we chose a passage from 1 Corinthians chapter 12. And as I read this passage several weeks ago in preparation for this series, I was just struck by the beautiful diversity that is present in these words. I could picture the diversity of our congregation and the different ways that God has brought us together and that we fit together. And so I had this crazy idea for doing scripture in a little different way today. I tossed it to Don and to Ron Freitag that does our videos for us. And I love that they were able to make this a reality. And so I ask you to join me in watching this video as we hear our scripture for today.
Today's scripture is from 1 Corinthians 12, verses 12 through 27.
For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ.
For in one spirit we are all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free.
And we were all made to drink of one spirit.
Indeed, the body does not consist of one member, but of many.
If the foot would say, because I am not a hand, I do not belong to the body, and that would not make it any less a part of the body.
And if the ear would say, because I am not an eye, I do not belong to the body, that would not make it any less a part of the body.
If the whole body were an eye, where would the hearing be? If the whole body were hearing, where would its sense of smell be?
But as it is, God arranged the members in the body, each one of them, as he chose.
If all were a single member, where would the body be? As it is, there are many members, yet one body.
The eye cannot say to the hand, I have no need of you. Nor again the head to the feet, I have no need of you.
On the contrary, the members of the body that seem to be weaker are indispensable.
And those members of the body that we think less honorable, we clothe with greater honor. And our less respectable members are treated with greater respect.
Whereas our more respectable members do not need this. But God has so arranged the body, giving the greater honor to the inferior member.
That there be no dissension within the body, but the members may have the same care for one another.
If one member suffers, all suffer together with it.
If one member is honored, all rejoice together with it.
Now you are the body of Christ.
And individually members of it.
This is the word of God
for the people of God.
Thanks be to God. What a beautiful representation of the diversity that we have, not only in this congregation, but as the body of Christ. Will you pray with me? Gracious God, may the words of my mouth, the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable in your sight. God, you are our rock and our redeemer. Amen. So this passage that we read today that Paul wrote to one of his churches talks about the importance of the different pieces of the body of Christ coming together for different functions. It talks about the importance of each piece having a part of the whole It talks about the importance of the parts working together to function together as one unit. It captures our call as the community of Christ. This idea of the body, I looked up and we've got over 200 bones in our physical body. We've got over 600 muscles. We've got cartilage, ligaments, veins, arteries, skin, fat, some of us more than others for sure, all working together in unison. As I stand here and speak, as we walk, as we move, so many different little pieces have to happen in order to perform any action. But yet it seems seamless as just one movement. That's what happens to us as we fulfill the work of Christ as well. There's not just one little piece that does something, but it's each and every one of us together with Christ as the head of this body of Christ. And it is our hope that our work together will seem as seamless to the world out there, so that we function together in the way that we are called together. Today, as we look at the importance of this, it's easy to hear this as an aspirational call, as something that Paul is saying, it would be really good if you could function in this way. If you were functioning as a healthy church, then maybe you can begin to use this as a guide. But that's not what Paul says. He says, this is who you are as the body of Christ. This is reality. This is something that is true because of the work that Christ has already done at the cross. We come to baptismal waters as people that are individuals, that are self-reliant. And we come out of those baptismal waters changed in deep ways. We are a part of that body. Whether we function in the right ways or not, that's another question. But I love that this passage is just pointing to the truth that is ours because of the work that Christ has done. Relationships are important. Think of the different friendships that you have with others. We have a different kind of relationship here within this church because it is grounded in the love of Christ. Elward Riovo is a monk that was active back in the 1100s. I love reading some of these older writings because I always think it's going to be just something that doesn't make sense for us today. And over I'm struck by the importance of the words and the relevance to my own Christian journey. And that's what I thought when I looked at his writings where he talked about friendship. He said he believes that there's three kinds of friendship. He said there are carnal friendships. He said those that are based on amusement, enjoying being around each other. They're what he called worldly friendships. And those are those that are said to be based on usefulness. What can I get from you? And then there are spiritual friendships. These are those that are based on a mutual commitment to Christ, that are grounded in the love of Christ. That's what we get to experience together. And that changes everything about friendship. Because it's no longer just the people that you would think you would be friends with. I love seeing the diversity of the relationships that are present in the church. People that you might think would not choose outside of these walls to hang out together just because lives are so different. They may be in different socioeconomic places, totally different careers, different family situation, people that wouldn't shop at the same place or go to the same restaurants, or their lives seem totally different. And yet here, there is a strong, strong bond because of the love of Christ. And as we heard in that video, each and every piece of this body is important. It's critical. No piece is indispensable. Every piece is indispensable. We each play an important role. And so the other thing that that passage talks about is the call to support one another. Not just that each piece is important, but that we have to live out the role for being a part of that. And that's why we talk about today load-bearing walls. That's our construction tie today. Load-bearing walls are something we probably don't give a lot of thought to, at least most of us, unless you're very construction-minded. We don't walk into a building and say, I think that's a load-bearing wall. That's not. But when one that needs to be there is gone, you know it. The structure crumbles. Those load-bearing walls are important because they support the weight. They not only hold it up, but they actually distribute the weight so that it's not so heavy in one place. They're a critical, critical part of building. The structure would crumble without them. I want you to think about that as it relates to our own life's journeys. There's a lot of weight on us, just like a building is heavy with bricks and steel and everything else that are in the walls that we don't see when they're all smooth and pretty. But there's lots of stuff behind that. And so it is with our lives. There's lots of heavy things that we might not show to the outside world because we're busy trying to make things look pretty like the walls too, right? But we need people to help us hold up that weight. And that's what the body of Christ does for us. We become load-bearing walls for one another. When one suffers, all suffer. When one rejoices, all rejoice. We pay attention and we support. I get to see this often when I sit in this role as pastor. I see you supporting one another. And sometimes we as ministry staff often get to be the recipient of that as well. It's a pretty humbling place to be. One place that this happens officially is through the SPRC. You may hear those letters thrown around and not know what they are, but that's our Staff Parish Relations Committee. It's the group of you that help take care of us as staff. And we get little cards and letters and special little ways of support, flowers on my birthday or different things, just to make sure that you as a congregation take care of us as church staff. I saw that happen here as we have been coming out of this time, difficult year plus of the pandemic. The SPRC wanted to make sure that the staff had some time for renewal. And so you've seen some of the ministry staff out this summer at different times. I'm going to be taking time in September for that. And in the same way we're talking about these load-bearing walls, we've been able to support and back each other up. When somebody's been out, somebody else steps in and helps carry that load. We're talking about how that's going to happen when I'm out too, so that the staff, the members of the congregation, different people help to carry that load. Ron Henderson, that was our district superintendent, he's retired now. We have Deborah Hobbs Mason is our new district superintendent, but he'll be here for a few weeks preaching in September when I'm out. It's a great example of the ways that we support one another in those roles. Sometimes we're the load-bearing wall, and sometimes we're the one that needs that weight distributed to help us out. Verse 26 talks about the ways that we support one another through the ups and downs. If one member suffers, all suffer with it. If one member is honored, all rejoice with it. We love and care for one another because of our connection through Christ. Philip Yancey is a writer. Some of you may have read some of his books. Theologian that was talking about this passage that we read today. And in referring to a physical body, he says a healthy body is not one that doesn't feel pain. In other words, to be healthy, it doesn't mean we have to be absent of pain. He says a healthy body is one that attends to the pain of its weakest part. That's what it means for us to be physically healthy, to realize what's happening, to realize those places that we have pain in our life, and therefore to respond to that. And that's what we are called to do as the greater body of Christ as well. We attend to one another's pain. We don't act like it's not there. We don't ignore it. We work really hard here in worship to plan a worship service, to make sure that we have places to address those painful things that are going on, to name the difficulties in prayer time and in other times in our service, in our own lives, in the community around us, in the world. It's important what we do here together. And we've had an opportunity to be online, to be virtual, to have more people be involved, and that's important. But there's something else equally important that happens just right outside of these walls of this worship center when people come through these doors. It's an opportunity to share that pain in a different way, to talk about what's going on in our lives. There's no substitute for that physical one-on-one in-person connection because we get to see what's happening with one another. We can see when that weight seems to be a little bit heavy. We can see that sparkle in someone's eye when things seem to be going really well and they have something wonderful to share. We give words of encouragement and support, and we never know how the Holy Spirit is using us to share that love of Christ with someone else. That's what it means to be a part of community, to be a part of this congregation, to be a part of the broader body of Christ. You heard on the video earlier some people name why they thought community was important. Teresa and Keen, as our SPRC, as our church council chair and lay leader, have each week talked about whatever topic we are going to be focusing on. You'll hear them in the next couple of weeks as we have a few more of these videos. And then each of the weeks, I asked one other person to give voice to the topic as well. We chose somebody that has a particular connection to whatever it is that we're talking about. And today, Scott and Kay shared about their difficult medical journey and why this church made a difference. It's hard to walk those difficult roads all by ourselves. And this passage that we read today reminds us that because of our baptism through Christ, we are never alone. We are called to walk that road together, to be that load-bearing wall for one another. And I hope that as you're sitting here, you are able to think of the many ways that people have been that support for you. I'm going to invite you as you go forth. You probably saw this structure sitting out there as you came in and thought, what is that wacky church doing now? So here's the answer to the question of what it is. We want to claim those important ways that this church has made a difference. I want you to think of the question, how does my church build me up? How has our church community made a difference? There may be a scripture that comes to mind. There may be a certain incident. Think of something that captures that. Why is it different to be sitting here as a part of the body of Christ versus being a part of a country club? There's a significant difference. We are blessed to be a part of that kind of community, of those kinds of spiritual friendships. And I hope that we will continue to live that out, not only here amongst us, but that we carry that outside the walls so that others encounter those same kind of supports. Will you pray with me? Gracious God, we are so grateful for the many ways that your love comes at us. If we open our eyes, we can see that love just being poured out all around us through our church family. God, just open our hearts so that we can see the needs around us, so that we can open ourselves to be a channel for your Spirit to work through us, so that we can take seriously our role to hold up that weight, to be the load-bearing wall for those that need a little help on this journey. Use us, God, so that we might faithfully follow Christ. In your name we pray. Amen.
It is through our tithes and our offerings that we as a church are united in the giving and contributing to the ministries of our into our community of this church. And we also begin to see the rewards of such faithful giving when we participate in the ministries that are going on around us. I invite you today to join with us as we prepare for our offering. I'd like to remind you that our offering baskets are found as we at each of our exits. There's one to the back, and there are two more to our up here to the front, and one to the back here as well. As you leave, if you're trying to find a place to leave your tithes and offerings, those are where you can leave them. Again, I also remind you, you can give online but through our church website as well. Let us give thanks today for our offerings and praise, and let's bless ask God's blessing upon them. Will we pray? Gracious God, you have blessed us greatly, and with the parts of what you have blessed us, we give to you. Lord, we pray that you would take these tithes, these offerings, and bless them. Bless the hands that will be using them in the ministries. They may continue to be an example of your love and your grace to the world around us. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Would you please stand and join with me as together we sing.
Jesus, in my heaven.
As we prepare to go forth to be load-bearing walls for the world, I invite you to consider what it means to open your eyes and your heart to see those needs around us. To consider the ways that the church makes a difference. Go out there and pick up a marker and claim that on one of these boards. I'm grateful to Larry Lambeth, who gave of his time to create that structure. Let's use it to bring praise to God for what is happening through our church family. Another way that we can support one another is by blessing one another. I hope that you feel blessed every time that you are here. If there's anything we can do for you as a church family, if you are looking for a church family, we would love to have you as a part of First Rowlett. You can talk to me or one of the other pastors after the service or reach out to us during the week. We'd love to have our local church family continue to grow. And so let's take a minute to look around at one another and to share a blessing together. Will you join me? May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.